important launch for us. This is our flagship. And the job of a flagship for a brand like ours is to really represent everything the brand stands for and represent it in a big way. And for our new 7 Series, there were 3 key areas of focus. First, Kareem described how we took a luxury sedan and made it an athletic, dynamic, driver-focused automobile. Next, we know that BMW's gotten where we are today by being an innovator. You've heard a lot about innovations. Well, we made certain our new 7 Series has more innovations than any other car in its segment, and we'll talk about some of those. Finally, we really wanted to elevate the levels of luxury to levels you've never seen before in the BMW. Levels of luxury is good or better than anyone else in the segment. Yet we wanted to achieve that without sacrificing one of the primary reasons people buy a BMW, and that's to have a fun to drive automobile. And we'll talk about how we achieve that. When you put it all together, that's our vision of the future of luxury. When you see this car, hopefully you're seeing a beautiful car in front of you, but sometimes what makes a car really special is what lies beneath, and that's particularly true of our new 7 Series. For years, manufacturers have used steel to build cars like this. Recently, a few have used aluminum. We're leapfrogging the competition using what we're calling a carbon core technology. It's a combination of aluminum, high-strength steel, and carbon fiber. You can see on the image where you see the bright, shiny parts up front, that's aluminum. The medium gray color is steel, and the darker pieces are the carbon fiber. And some things to note, we're using each of those materials where it makes the most sense and it does the best benefit for the automobile, for the occupants. Up front, reducing weight up front to help us achieve that near 50-50 weight balance that we strive for. So use aluminum up front to help with that. And using carbon fiber around the passenger cell. You know how strong carbon fiber is. It's half the weight of steel for a given strength. And we're protecting the occupants with really surrounding them with carbon fiber. But we're also using that carbon fiber to save weight up high by using in the A-pillar in the roof. What we're doing is reducing weight up high, which allows us to have a lower center of gravity. Our new 7 Series has a lower center of gravity than its predecessor. And as Ian mentioned, you put it all together, you save a tremendous amount of weight. Unlike the i3 and unlike the i8, the carbon fiber is not visible. So what we've done is it's all underneath the skin. But what we've done is put a carbon core badge on the B-pillar to communicate that the car has carbon fiber underneath. And you take that weight savings, you combine it with a very powerful twin power turbo V8, you've got great performance. Our X-Drive version gets to 60 in 4.3 seconds. To put it in perspective, that's nearly as quick as today's M5. It's half a second quicker to 60 than an S550. Great, great dynamics. A powerful engine and a lightweight is not enough. You want to have a great suspension. And our engineers have worked extremely hard to reduce weight, and in particular, to reduce unsprung weight. Our new 7 Series has 15% less unsprung weight than its predecessor. You can see all these components, a lot of attention to detail using either aluminum or aluminum steel, and in some cases, doing the best we can with steel. And it's a small thing, but you can hear. You can see the wheel hub for the current generation 7 Series, and then on the right for our all new 7 Series. And it's not a big deal, but this kind of attention to weight savings detail is carried out throughout the automobile to make it lighter and better. Our new 7 Series has a four-pointer air suspension, two-axle air suspension. The air suspension has a real advantage at low speeds, or if you're in a parking lot, you need to raise the car a little bit because you have an angle of approach issue with a parking garage, you can do that. The car is always level. In sport mode at high speeds, the suspension drops the car a little bit, once again, to lower the center of gravity and improve the dynamic characteristics. We have an all-new Autobot package where we've combined a lot of the great new technology that we have to make our suspensions better to really come up with something that really makes a big impact on the car. Dynamic damper control you're familiar with, integral active steering, you've seen it before, the rear wheel steer in phase with the front wheels at high speeds and opposite the front wheels at low speeds. Our long wheelbase version of our new 7 Series is as maneuverable in low-speed parking situations as yesterday's short wheelbase, so it does really help us with maneuverability. Active comfort drive with road preview, so the start and stop cameras up front are scanning the road and adjusting the suspension before you get there, and we have a bigger brakes and more aggressive brake pads. And really, you'll have a chance to drive it tomorrow. The cars you'll be driving the track have this package, and what's exciting, it makes a big luxury sedan feel like a car one or two sizes smaller. So looking forward for your comments tomorrow. We have an adaptive transmission. That's not new, but what's interesting for BMW, we have the transmission speaking to the navigation system. The adaptive part of the transmission adjusts for how you're driving, but now what it's doing, to make certain we're picking the exact right shift map strategy, the transmission knows what's coming up ahead. It takes that data to help make certain you're in the right gear when you get there. As we mentioned, really elevating levels of luxury inside the interior, but not just focusing on traditional luxury. What we want to do is introduce a lot of innovations and technology to make being inside our new 7 Series a very special emotional experience. We're using the finest Napa leather we can get, very delicate, intricate diamond stitch pattern. There's an optional Alcantara headliner. The front seats have 8 different massage programs at 3 different levels of intensity. So everything you'd expect. In the back, most importantly, class-leading rear seat legroom. Means showing you the executive lounge seat package. Really, everything you expect back here, massaging, reclining seats, and all the comfort. You can even turn the back of the car into a mobile office with a fold-out work tray. See that in this car tonight and also once again tomorrow. Now probably the most important thing in the back is rear seat entertainment. We probably have one of the best systems out there. 2 10-inch screens, you have a Blu-ray DVD or an HDMI port. You also have the option of turning your car into a Wi-Fi hotspot. If you have a Netflix account, for instance, you can stream programs to your phone and play that through those screens, watch programs as you ride in the back. Now controlling everything is our new tablet. The tablet resides in the center console. When it's residing in there, it's being charged, but you can pop it out, hold it in your hand, and use it to control basically everything that's going on in the back. The reclining seats, the heat functions, the window shades, even the rear heated armrests. And the controls are simple, easy, intuitive to use, and make it fun. In the U.S., we've made a panoramic moonroof standard on all cars, but we also have something new. It's a Sky Lounge LED roof. What we have done is there's 15,000 etchings in the roof. This is an optional package. Or LED lights along the side. And what happens when the LED lights travel through the glass and they hit one of those etchings, it illuminates that etching. And our designers come up with a great pattern that sort of lifts the roof and makes being inside our new 7 Series a really special place to be, in particular at night. Now we've worked with a French perfume supplier. We've developed 8 scents unique to our BMW. You load up a cartridge, there's a button in the climate control system in the center that activates those scents. You select one, there's 3 different intensity levels, and it really helps. It also, with this package, an air ionization technology that helps purify the air that's inside the car, make it easier to breathe while you're driving. You see, we focus a lot on things that you see and touch and things that you smell, but also what you hear inside the BMW is particularly important. For over 50 years, Bowers & Wilkins have been developing great home stereo systems. And they're known as being an innovator in terms of design and in types of materials they use for their speakers. They use Kevlar, for instance, in some of their mid-range speaker surrounds. And they developed this all-new diamond tweeter coated technology that really allows them to most accurately reproduce high-frequency sound. And we're the first manufacturer to take that diamond tweeter technology and put it into an automobile. 16 speakers, 1,400 watts of power, and I'm looking forward to you getting to listen to it when you drive the car tomorrow. Now back in 2001, we really tried to revolutionize how you, the driver, communicates to your car, and we did that when we launched our iDrive system. And really, it really changes, made a lot of things simple, and at the time, we did have a few complaints, maybe it's a little bit complicated, but we've worked really hard over the years to improve that system. Now we probably have one of the best. We really wanted to change once again how you communicate with your car with a roll of 7 Series, and we're launching iDrive 5. It's our 5th generation of iDrive, and it lets several great new ways to communicate with your car. The iDrive controller is still there. It functions just as it did in the past. The touchpad on top is still there, and we have a much improved voice activation system. But we are launching, for the first time in the BMW, a touchscreen. Now, there are most of the functions you'll still use, the iDrive controller, the voice, or the touchpad, just as before. But there are some functions that are particularly useful on a touchscreen. You can see how you can swipe sideways and up and down between menus and pages. But this system becomes really valuable when you're operating the navigation system. We have what we call a pinch zoom feature. Instead of operating the controls, you just touch the screen, pinch zoom in or out, and the nav changes its focus. If you want to move around the map, just touch the screen and move your finger left or right, and you get to move around and see where you're going. So it takes something that used to be fairly awkward and makes it much more convenient and easy to use. Now, the all-new one, one we're very proud of, is gesture control. I'm from New Jersey. We've been using gestures for years while we drive, but BMW found a way to make it productive. And what you have is several different ways to control the car with gestures. There's an infrared sensor in the headliner. It's looking, when you put your hand over the shifter, it's sensing what's going on. If you want to raise the volume of the audio system, simply move your hand over the shifter and rotate your finger clockwise. If you want to lower the volume, rotate your finger counterclockwise. If a phone call comes in, you want to accept it, just point towards the screen, you've accepted the call. If a call comes in, you want to reject it, just swipe your hand across the screen, call's rejected. And what you can see, once you try this once, these are simple, easy to learn, intuitive controls. And actually, after a while, you do it without even thinking, so they're that special. The most important one, as Ian mentioned, our two-finger point gesture. This is a programmable gesture. When you're sitting in your driveway programming, setting up the car, you set this for the function that you want to access maybe the most quickly or the most that you do the most frequently. And for me, without a doubt, it's having the app system wake up, sending me home, you set it up, and it really makes that whole function very, very easy to use. It really, really changes how you drive and communicate with the car. When you're parking, we have a 360-degree spin feature. Typically, and sometimes in parking, there's a lot going on. Well, now, very easy to get a great perspective everywhere around the car by just moving your hand left to right. Added up, we have 25 all-new interfaces on our new 7 Series, and 13 of those are not available on any other car or any other manufacturer. Some others, wireless charging for your cell phone. There's a sleeve in the center console. Drop your phone in, and it charges wirelessly. Next, we have an all-new display key. There's a Gorilla LCD display, a Gorilla Glass, just like it is on your iPhone, and it communicates all sorts of important information. If you've ever walked away from your car and you've forgotten, have I locked the doors, have I left the windows open, you don't have to go back now. The key will tell you. It also communicates all sorts of things, fuel, whether the car needs to be serviced. There are two batteries in the system. One battery drives the screen, and a second battery is used to lock or unlock the car. So if the screen, if you played with it and burned out the battery, you can still get in your car. And you can charge that key in the wireless pocket in the center console. As Ian mentioned, autonomous driving is available. It's technology that exists, but there's a lot of legislative insurance industry issues that will slow down how that is rolled out. What we've tried to do at BMW is take that technology and improve how you interact and make driving safer and make the BMW driver a smarter driver. First, we have a much improved head-up display system, 75% larger, full color. It even displays the speed limit sign. What's really new about our new car is that when you set the speed limit will now increase or decrease as the speed limit goes up or down. It's really helping you keep you safer. Next, a very sophisticated frontal collision warning system. You've seen experience it before, you've seen it on the TV ads. What I really like about it is the brake preconditioning that we have. If the car senses the collision is a possibility, it flashes a warning. But also what it does when it flashes that warning is it preconditions the brakes so that the instant you touch that pedal, you have maximum braking. The reason is not everybody always pushes that pedal as quickly or as hard as they need to get the maximum braking effort. And now we've taken that over for the driver. But as soon as you let up on the pedal, you're back to full brake control, but really delivering for many customers shorter braking distances in real life. Next, traffic jam assist. As Ian mentioned, you know, in a traffic jam, you could be cruising, the adaptive cruise control will stop when the car in front stops, the car will start to follow and always maintain a safe distance, but now the car will start steering for you. If you want to take your hands off the wheel for a few seconds and put on your sunglasses, you can do it. If the road's turning while you're doing that, the car will steer and keep you in that lane. It's really giving you a little bit of a taste of what autonomous driving will be like in the future. Next, helping with parking. Active PDC will now not just warn you when you're reversing and coming up to an obstacle, will actually apply the brakes to stop the car before you hit something. And also a surround view with a 3D perspective. Very often when you're parallel parking, it can be hard to judge how close you are to the curb. Well, now with our new 3D perspective, you get the exact right angle you need to see how close that front wheel is getting. And what I really like about this feature is that when I'm parking, I can now hear and see when I scratch the wheel. We also have introduced for our new 7 Series what we call BMW Ultimate Benefits. It's a lot of things that you'd expect The one thing that needs a little bit of explanation is our BMW Encore. This refers to an Encore delivery. There is a lot of new technology on our car. It can be overwhelming and tough to digest at all when you pick up the car on that first day. So what we offer is that we'll meet with someone from this dealership. We'll meet with a client wherever and whenever he wants and do a second delivery. And what's good, after 2 or 3 weeks of ownership, you've raised a lot of questions. And what we find is that second delivery is critically important. It really elevates the level of understanding our owners have with the new car. Retail launch is October 24th. You can see the lineup in the U.S. One important thing to note, we have eliminated the short wheelbase 7 series. The vast majority of our sales were the long wheelbase. And when we have eliminated it, we've also eliminated the L. So when you see a 750i on our new 7 series, it's actually the old 750li. Put it all together, a real focus on a great design that communicates. This is an athletic, dynamic automobile at levels of luxury you've never seen before in a BMW. An amazing list of innovations, more than anyone else in the segment. And when you put it all together, that's our vision of the future of luxury. But as good as any description is here, really you've got to get behind the wheel and drive it, and that's what tomorrow's set up for. So hopefully you'll have a lot of fun tomorrow.